Morning, everyone. My name is Shadi, and I'm the head of engineering at Amplitude. I am so excited to be here with all of you to share how we are solving these hard problems. The motivation behind product intelligence is to help you and your team to collaborate and solve customer pain. We want you to build the connect the dots, build for growth, and make better user experiences with the data. As I'm trying to share how we are doing that, I'm going to walk you through some of the challenges that one of our customers, Guillermo, who is a co-founder and product lead at Rappi, was facing. I believe a number of you in the audience can relate. Rappi is the largest on-demand delivery service in Latin America. They're valued over $2.5 billion, and they're operating in 55 cities. When we met Guillermo and the team, they didn't trust the data they were collecting. They couldn't track the number of users that were joining every month, and metrics such as conversion were always being debated and questioned for accuracy. This was a distraction for the team. Actually, accurately tracking the user count is not a problem unique to Rappi. With users constantly moving from one device to another device, sometimes appearing as an anonymous user, sometimes appearing as a logged-in user, it's hard to put that end-to-end view together. I'm sure some of you are feeling that pain as well. At Amplitude, we have built our, about the past 4 years, we have built our identity resolution program that we believe is the best in the industry. We keep track of all of these anonymous users with their associated device ID so we can link them all together when the user authenticates. And we do it retroactively, and unlike some other solutions out there, we don't have any limit on how many users and IDs we can merge. For some data set, we need to take it a step further. The data set that needs more love and attention, the one that they don't have any naming convention, the one that there's only one person in the organization know what they mean and they're always so busy to explain it to anybody else. Our taxonomy product helps to clean up this messy data by allowing you to write rules, to merge events, fix erroneous values, or drop some data field altogether. You can do it for, we can do it for historical data as well as the future data. Some work happens at ingestion time, some will happen at query time. But you don't need to worry about it. All you have to do is set up your rules in our UI and we'll take care of the rest for you. So how did this help Guillermo? You remember he was stuck. After using Amplitude, they started to trust their data. And nowadays, there are 250 users in Rappi from across the entire organization working together every week in Amplitude on the same data. These people are in Guillermo's team, as well as marketing, support, engineering, working all together toward the same shared goal. There are no silos there. So after Rappi and Guillermo trusted their data, now they want to ask 1,000 questions about the data to gain more insight. But they don't want to wait 3 weeks to get their answers. One of my favorite quotes is this quote by Albert Einstein. Basically, what he's saying is that the most important step in any problem-solving process, and actually the hardest one, is to ask the right question. When you get that right, the rest is easy. We build Amplitude based on the premise that usually the first time you ask a question is not the right question. You ask one question based on the result of that question, you ask another one, and you go on and on until you get to something actionable. One of the questions that Guillermo had was that, can I use Rappi's free delivery subscription program to increase the number of orders that new users place? To be able to answer that question and predict the behavior of the user, first he needed to answer another question. He needed to know how does the behavior of subscriber is different from non-subscribers. Comparing the behavior of one segment of a user with another segment of user is what we call cohorting at Amplitude. And it's central to everything that we do. Our cohort builder allows you to create custom segments based on any attributes of the user. It can be the action the user took, it can be the properties of the user, the life cycle, or any other things you want. And you don't need to know SQL to do that. I'm sure you all know SQL, but just in case. The underlying technology that helps us achieve that is our own distributed columnar storage. Basically, for any solution to be able to handle getting all of these data and answering these questions on the fly, it has to have a distributed architecture to scale. At the same time, we want our users to ask hard questions that are not known ahead of time. Basically, we need to be able to do complex distributed joins on the fly. We looked at solutions out there and we realized there is no other technology that does that for us. And that's why we build our own solution from ground up, which we call Nova. Nova can process more than 1 billion events in less than 1 second and help you answer these hard questions, including cohorting, no matter how many users you have. You might have millions and millions of users. If you ever use Amplitude, you know one of the most fun things is to start from one analysis and pivot to another analysis. So you might be starting at a funnel analysis, and then you go deep down into one data point. Going there, you can create a cohort. And then you can look at the behavior on that cohort in another analysis like retention. That's what we call fluid workflow at Amplitude. This fluid workflow helped Guillermo and the team to figure out that not only the subscriber placed 3 times more orders than non-subscriber, they are 2.5 times more likely to retain. Armed with that knowledge, they decided to double down. So Guillermo and the marketing team worked together to put together a trial program, a low-cost trial program, focus on new users. And that was really successful. Speaking of marketing, anybody else's personal mailbox look like mine? Okay, it's good to know I'm not alone. No companies we have ever met like to blast users with email and push notification because they think it's fun. They do it because that's all they can do with the data they have. This is another example of the case that Justin was talking about a little bit earlier. The tool that they're using lacks any behavioral context. A number of our customers, Ravi included, came to us with that pain. They said, if we use the data that we already have in Amplitude, all of the cohorts and other insights that we have, we can really increase our engagement significantly. And that's why we worked and built and launched Amplitude Engage recently. Amplitude Engage basically turns your product data into a targeting engine that powers your personalized campaign and experiences. All you need to do is go and set up your cohort or create another one on the fly and set your syncing cadence with your destination. It's easy to target users based on their life cycle, behavior context, possibility of churn, or likelihood of purchase, or any other things. And our integration takes care of automatically calculating the cohort on the fly and pushing to the destination and also reconciling the user that you have on your other tool versus Amplitude. And the most important step is that you can actually measure the impact because you're closing the loop and you can see how your targeting campaign impacts your user behavior. Engage is a powerful tool, not just because we are connecting to one messaging or marketing tool. It's because it's pushing your behavioral context through your entire stack. We built Engage to support scale and syncing hundreds of cohorts to your large-scale lifecycle marketing. And we have customers who use Engage to inject this behavioral context into 60% of all of the communication that they do with their users. Today, Engage has integration with Marketo, Facebook, Linplum, Braze, Iterable, Airship, Intercom, and Segment. And soon we will add Salesforce, Google, and AppQs. Rappi actually used Engage, and the result was a win-win situation. The customer were receiving more personalized and relevant information. And for Rappi, it decreased the cost of new customer acquisition by 30%. That is a perfect example of using product data to build product experiences for growth. To sum it up, we build product intelligence to help you use your product data to build the execution gap and build better experiences. So let me leave you with this. Product intelligence is a can of spinach, and you are Popeye. So when you are ready to pack a big punch, you know where to find us. We'd love to help you build product experiences for growth. Thank you.